This conference will now be recorded.
So in today's topic, I am going to discuss about computer networking and IP address. So what is a computer network? So computer network means we are connecting computers for purpose of sharing resource. So we want to share some folders, or we want to share the printers or internet or email, we want to share. So computer want to share the resource, we are calling it as a computer network. So there is different type of network, LAN, WAN, MAN, PAN. So what is a LAN? LAN means we are connecting computers inside a building or inside a campus is called a LAN. So if we are connecting two networks, that is beyond geographical distance. Maybe we have one network in India, in Bangalore, another network in US, in California. So we are connecting two network, we are calling it as a wide area network. So we are connecting computers in different ways. Either we can connect through a wide area, we can connect through wireless. So we can see that computers are connected to a wireless access point. So it's a central device. Or we can connect computers using a, we will connect all computer, we will connect to a network. Maybe we will connect to a main computer. This is called a server. But physically, how we are connecting the computers? All the computers are connected to a central device called a switch. The switch is a device used for connecting different computers. Previously, we used as hub, but now we are using switch. So we can see this is the diagram of a, this is a picture of a switch. So all the computers cable will be connected to the switch. And how we are connecting this? We are using a cable. So we use a network cable. This cable is called Ethernet cable, also called as UTP cable, unshielded twisted pair cable. And every computer will have a network card. So if we want to connect computer to the network, every computer require this network card. But nowadays, all computers having inbuilt network cards. So we are connecting two different networks in different area, different regions or different geographical location. We are calling it as a wide area network. So when we want to connect, we want to make a wide area network, we required routers. So switch is mainly using in local area network, but routers are used to connect between different locations or different networks. So we can say router is a internetworking device, mainly using in wide area network, also uses for connecting different networks. So we can see that these two branch offices are connected using some connection. So both the side routers are there, routers are connected to some modem, and it is connected to the other branch. So when we are using a network uses some protocol. So what is the protocol means? It is similar to a language. So computer used to communicate, or we can say that it's a set of rules that telling how we are formatting the data and sending in the network. So it's a set of rules telling how data is sending in the computer. We know that when we are sending the data in the network, we are making the data into small units called packets. So how these packets are made, everything is mentioned in the protocol. Everything is specified in the protocol. So there are different protocols. Previously, every manufacturer uses their own protocols, because Apple uses their own protocol, Apple TAC, or Novell, another company uses IPX, XPX, Windows use NetBU, NetBU UI. So they uses different protocol. But nowadays, every company uses a common protocol called TCP/IP, because everything is based on internet. So they want to connect to internet. So they need TCP/IP protocol. So TCP/IP means Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. It's a widely use the protocol now. So when we want to use TCP/IP, so we need to do some configuration. So we have to give some number for this. We have to give some number called IP address, something called a subnet mask. All this configuration information we have to give to the computer. So we can go to the control panel, and we have to give this IP address. So in a computer, I want to give the IP address. I can give this IP address in the control panel. So I am going to control panel. So there is Ethernet means network card. I can go to properties. And I have the option to give this number. So IP address is something like similar to some number. Like when we purchase a mobile, we have to give a number for this mobile. We have to buy a SIM card and we have to give a number. Similarly, here we can give a number for this computer. So for example, I can give like this 200, 100, 50, 10. So this, I am giving a number to this computer. This is called a IP address. So I will be explaining about this IP address now. So IP address is a 32-bit binary number. As we know, computers work on binary number. Human beings use decimal number, but computers are using binary numbers. For example, I am just writing an example. So this is just an example. If we count this, this is 32-bit is there. So this is IP address. This is an example of an IP address. But when we are telling this IP address, what we will do, we will make this IP address into four sections. So whenever we got this number, so what we used to do, we divide this number into four sections. And we can say, we can convert this number to decimal. So this is a binary number which computer use, and we can convert this to a binary number by using this calculator convert to binary. So we can do a conversion through mathematics. So we can use some converter to do conversion. So when we convert this, we can see that we will get a number like 192. So this number is equal to 192. So I am writing here. So when we convert, I will get this number 192. So I am writing this number here. And the second number is, if I convert this, so when I convert, I will get 168. So this number I am getting as 168. So the next number I convert, I will get a 0. So the next number I convert, I will get 1. So now this is a 32-bit number, but I divided into four sections. Each one is 8 bits. And I will get the number like this, 192, 168, 0.1. So now it is easy for me to remember this number, but because I cannot remember this complete number, this number I can remember. So this IP address is having four sections, and the maximum number we can give is 255. Why? Because if we are making all this as one, so this is equal to 255. So that is the reason IP address is having four sections. Each section maximum we can have value of to 55. So this is the IP address we have to give to the computer. So another computer, we have to give another number. Like our mobile number, we are giving different numbers or unique numbers. So that we will be giving in the control panel of the computer, we can give the IP address. So I will go to my control panel. I can see this. So I can go to control panel and I can go to control panel. There is one option called network, and there I can give this IP address to this computer. So I will go to Ethernet, means there is a network card in the system. I am going to Ethernet properties. So I'm going to give the IP address. So I can type a IP address like this, 192.168.0.1 IP I am giving. And here we have to know there is one more number is there called subnet mask. So we are giving IP address as well as we are giving another number called subnet mask. So why we are giving this subnet mask? So in this case, we can say we are using IP address as this one, and subnet mask we had seen before. They are using 3 255s and zero. So this is the subnet mask we are using. So why we are using this subnet mask like this? So this is my IP address, and this is called a subnet mask. So why we are using subnet mask? So this is having a purpose. We know that if we are in India, the India code is 0091. So that means in India, anywhere, if you go, the code of the country is 0091. Suppose we go to US, this is the code for US. Anywhere if you go, their code is 001. Similarly, we are saying this IP address, if I tell a number like this, we know that this number having two sections, this is my country code, and this is my phone number, mobile number. So this number, as we know, there is two parts. One is my country code, one is my mobile number. Similarly, in this IP address, we are telling there is two parts. One is my network part. So this is my IP address. I am telling this is my network number. The first, maybe this number and this number and this number is my network number. And this is my client number. So what it means is this first three numbers I am making as network number. So I am just comparing this like our country code or STD code. So what we are saying, in a network, all the computers, we have to keep this number common. And we are changing only the last number only we are changing. So we are saying the first three number is like our network number. This will be same in my office or my network, in my office. And the last number only I will change. And how much I can change? As we discussed before, we can change from 0 to 255 because this is a 8-bit number. We can change from 0 to 255. So, and we cannot tell this network, English computer will not understand. So what we used to do, instead of network, we will write subnet mask as 255, 255, 255. So it is a code, so the computer understands whatever coming above 255 is network portion. So in this case, the computer understand there is 3 255 is there. That means whatever coming above 255 is network portion. So our network portion is first three numbers. So we will change only the last number. So we will just do a simulation. We will do some software and we will practice this. So I am using some packet tracer, some software. This is just a software for studying purpose. So I am just opening this Cisco packet tracer and I will be doing a simulation. So we are saying that when the computer having IP address and the computer having this subnet mask. So I will be showing this in this picture. So I'm doing this. So now I am making, I am just connecting three computers. So I am making some simulation. I am connecting two, three computers to a switch. So the computers generally will be connected to a central device called a switch. So these computers using network card, this is an example of network card. I am connecting three computer. Just I am doing a model of this or original network. So I am connecting all the computer to the switch and I am giving some IP address. So I am giving IP address like this. .168.0.1. So second computer I am giving IP address 192.168.0.2. So in this case we can understand the first three numbers I am using common, I am using same. So I will go to first computer. This is just a simulation. I am using this IP, I am giving a IP address. So 192.168.0.1 IP I am giving. So and I am giving second computer, I give a IP address. So I am giving a IP address like 192.168.0.2 I am giving. So one thing we have to note now is the first three number is common. So that means I am subnet mask, I am using 3255. That means whatever coming above 255 is network portion. So these three numbers I am giving common. So now I can see my IP address by going to command prompt. I will give a command called ipconfig to see the IP address of my machine. So ipconfig is a command to see the IP address of my system. And I am using another command ping to check the connection between two system. So I am using ping and I am giving the IP address of my other system. I use ping, I will give space and I will ping the other system. I can see that it is pinging to the other computer. So it is working. So these two computers having a connection. So now in the third computer, I am going to give another IP. So I am going to give IP like 192.168.5.3. So in this case, we have to make note these three numbers is not same with the first computer. So now if I am going to this computer and I am going to ping to the that computer, I am going to ping 192.168.5.3. So this by default will not work because it is two different network. So as per our discussion, the first three number must be same, then only they will able to ping or communicate. So ping is a command to check the connection. So if I want to make it correct, so what I have to do, I have to make this first three numbers same, then only I will be able to communicate. So I will go to first computer and now if I try to ping that IP 0.3, so this is going to ping. So in the, by default, these computers are connected to a switch. They are able to connect if they are in the same network. So maybe I am using another network I am going to use. So I use a 2-3 computer here. So and I am going to use another network. So this is my, this network is my network is called 192.168.0.0 network. So I am putting 0 here. That meaning is the first three number is my network number. So I am going to make another network here. Maybe I have another office in another location. So I am going to use another network 192.168.2.0 network I am using. So here all the computers first three numbers I am making like this. So this may be my another office. So I am going to connect all these computers to the switch. Now I am going to give the IP address to the computer. So I am going to give an IP address like 192.168.2.1. So I am using a different network here. This is like a different country or something like that. So I am giving another IP, 192.168.2.2. So this machine, I am going to give an IP like 192.168.2.3. So these three computers will be able to connect. So I can go to ping to the other computer. My IP, I can see by IP config command. So when I am pinging ping 192.168.2.2 and all, I can ping. But I am not able to ping to the other network. So this is one network, left is one another network. Suppose I want to connect these two different networks. So there is a method, I have to use a router in between. So I am using a device called a router. So router is used to connect a different network. Basically, it is a wide area network device. So I am connecting two devices using a router. And the router, we can give IP address. Like computers, we will give IP address. I'm clicking on the router and I have the option to give some IP address to the router. I will be giving some IP 0.254. And I'm giving another IP 192.168.2.254. So these two IPs are in the two different range. I'm clicking on. So now this computer, this router having two IPs. One IP is 192.168.0.254. It is connected to this. It is in the same range of this left. And in the right side, I have another IP I am giving 192.168.2.254. It is from the second network. Now, one more thing I have to do is whenever we giving the IP address, we discussing, there is one more option called a default gateway. So why we are using default gateway? Default gateway is called router address. So when we want to connect outside network, other than our local network, we want to connect, we have to go to the gateway. So in this case, in our diagram, so I am giving the gateway address. So each computer, I have the option to give the gateway. So my gateways are 192.168.0.254. That is a router address. And in the second computer also, I will give the gateway address, same gateway address. That is my router address. 192.168.0.254 I am giving. And third computer also, I will give the gateway address 192.168.0.254. So because this gateway, this is the router address I am giving. And the right side network, I will go to computer. I will give my IP as 192.168.2.254. And all the computers, I will give that. So I will go to the computer, I will give the IP 192.168.2.254 I am giving. So even the last computer, I can give that 192.168.2.254 I am giving. So now I am trying to connect from this computer to another network. So my IP is this one. This is my IP. I want to connect to a computer in another network, 192.168.2.1. So I am from here, I am connecting to another computer in the another network. So now this communication has to pass through the router and it has to reach. See, now it is pinging to another IP that is not in the same network. This communication is going through the router and doing. So when I do some command trace route, it will show the complete route. So I am using 192.168.2.1. So it will see that it is going through the router and it is going through the another computer. It's a command to see the route of the packet, route of your communication. So that we are saying now. So we are saying that we are giving a computer an IP. So IP is 192.168.0.1. And the subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. So we have a computer having an IP like this. And there is a subnet mask. Subnet mask is like this. So like this IP address and subnet mask. So what is the three subnet mask meaning? So this whatever coming about 255 is my network portion. So in my case, I have three network portions. So how much, what is my client portion? The last number is my client portion. So in every computer, I will change only this number. All in a network, I will use this first three number as common. Now in this case, maximum clients I can give is, I can last number only I am changing. So I can give maximum IP address 0 to 256. So I will not give it 0 and 256 to 255 to the client. Maximum I can use 254 clients. So this network is called class C network. So class C network is maximum clients I can use is 254, because I will not use 0, I will not use 255 to the computer. But in a network, if you want more than this IP, so we have to use class B network. So in we want more than 254 clients in our network. So there is a class B network. So what is the class B network? So I am giving some IP address 172.16.10.1. And I am using subnet mask in different way. So I am using subnet mask like 255.255.0.0. So I am giving IP, this is my IP, and bottom is my subnet mask. So subnet mask is, I am using two 255s. So what it is meaning? So whatever coming above 255 is my network portion. So in all the computers, the first two numbers I have to keep common, and that last numbers are my client portion. The last two numbers are my client numbers. So all the computers in my network, this two number I have to make common, and I can change this number also and this number also in my clients. So here I will get a maximum clients. I will get 256 into 256. So I will get some 65536 clients. Maybe I have to minus 2 because I will not use 0 or 255. So I will use some this many clients I can use. So this network is called class B. So if I am using a IP like this, so I am giving a IP like 172.16.10.1. Computer automatically understand it is a class B network. So they are using 255s. So in all the computers, I have to use this first two numbers common. So that is class B network. So if we want more big network, so I can use a client class A network. So class A network means, so I have to use IP, suppose I'm using IP like 10.0.0.1, 10.10.10.1. So, and I am using my subnet mask as 255.0.0 and 0 I am using. So my IP is like this. So what it is meaning? So whatever coming about 255, so my class A network means I uses 1255 as subnet mask. So my network portion is 10. So in all the computers, I have to use 10 as common, and other three numbers I can change. So the maximum clients I can use is 256 into 256 into 256. And I have to minus 2. So what is class C address? When I use, this is my subnet mask, this is class C network. That means first three numbers is my network address. So class B means first two, I am using 2255 as subnet mask. So what it is meaning? This is my network number. So when I use 1.255 as subnet mask, it is called class A network. So my network number is 10. Whatever coming above 255 is my network number, or like my is similar to my IST code. And these three numbers I can change in the clients. So this is basics about different classes. And there are other classes are there. Class B and class C is there. We are not discussing. And when we see a number like this, I am using this number 192.168.0.1. So when I see this number, so when I check the first number, the what is the first number here? The first number is first number in this case is 192. So if I take the first number, so if it is 192 is my first number, if this first number is coming between 1 to 126, so this is will be a class A network. So they have some rule for this. If we check the first number, if it is coming between 1 to 126, it is a class A network. So if it is between 128 to 191, second number, first number is between 128 to 199, so this is a class B network. So if this is 192 to 223, so this is a class C network. So what I am saying is, suppose I got an IP address starting from 100. So 100, 100, 100, 100. So I have to check this first number. It is coming in this range. So this is a class A network. If I got an IP address starting from 200, so this is coming in this range, it is a class C network. By seeing an IP address, we can understand so which class this IP is belonging to. And there is another classes are there, 224 to 239, it is called multicast class D. But right now we are not discussing this. These are about different classes. So next thing I am discussing is there is two type of IP address, private IP and public IP. So what is public IP means? Private IP and public IP. So what is public IP means? That means publicly it is accessible. So whatever IPs we are having for public websites, that means Google, Yahoo, or Microsoft.com, all these things, this they have permanent IPs, they are purchasing from ISPs or providers. So this is public IP, so that need to be purchased. So now private IP means what they are saying inside the organization, and they can use some IP internally, and that not need to be purchased. Internally the organization, they can use some IPs. Suppose I want to see the IP of Google, so I can go to command prompt. So I give the command ping google.com. So if I do the ping command, it will show the connection, and it is showing the IP of Google. So IP is 216.58.200.142. This is a public IP address. Also one more command, I can see the IP address. I will do ns lookup, and I type www.google.com. It is supposed to see show the IP address. So it is showing some IP address for Google. So this may method also, you can see the IP address. So whatever IP the Google is having, it is called a public IP. So private IP means inside the organization, companies can use the IPs, because inside the organization, they may be using a large number of systems, thousands or systems, companies, organizations will use. So in the inside the organization, they can use some IPs, they are giving some range. So if we are using some IP internally, the organization, we should use these ranges only. So either we use any of these three ranges. So we have to use any of these three ranges. So you can also use this range. So each one is belonging to one class. This 192 is, this is class C, and this is class B, and this is class A. So each class, there is a group, a range of IP address. So if you are going to use IP address inside our organization, So either we can use these three ranges, starting from 190 to 168, 170 to 16, to 170 to 31, or starting from 10. So as we know, 10 is from the class A, this is from class B, and this is from class C. So if we want to use IP address internally, we have to use this range, three ranges. So that is called private IP address. And we can give IP address to the system in two ways, static IP address and dynamic IP address. So what is static IP means? We are giving IP address manually to the system. So every computer, I can go to control panel and I can type the IP address manually. And there is another option, obtain an IP address automatically. So what it will do, when you give out static means administrator has to manually type IP. But dynamic means, so it will get IP address, computers, systems will get IP address automatically from a server. So that server is called a DHCP server. So computer will be getting IP from a server called dynamic host configuration protocol server. So when we are using computer systems in our home, we are not giving an IP address. Or maybe when we use systems in the office, we will not give IP address manually, but this computer will get IP address automatically from a server. That server is called DHCP server. So there is two methods of giving IP address. So if we are giving static IP address, there is lot of administrator work, because the IT administrator has to go to every computer and he has to manually type the IP. And if he is typing same IPs in two machines, or maybe he will make some manual mistake, so there will be a possibility is there, two computer may have two same IPs, or we will be typing IPs by mistake. But when we are doing through dynamic, computers will get IP address automatically. But there is one drawback. If we are using dynamic IP and if this server is maybe available, not available, if the DHCP server is down, maybe our complete network may go down. But nowadays, DHCP server uses many fault tolerant methods. They use high availability methods. They will use clustering, all the things. But what there is another type of IP address. So there is another IP address that is coming like this, 169.254.0.0.2. 169.254.255.255. So this range is called APIPA range. So previously we discussed about three private IP address ranges. This is another range. So what they are saying, when DHCP server is not available, so the client will take a IP from this range. So when the DHCP server is not available, so not generally previously what used to happen, clients will get IP address like 0000, but now they will automatically take a IP from this range, and this range is called APIPA, APIPA IP address. So we have this IP address. And next thing is, when we are configuring IP address, there is one DNS server address. So what is the function of the DNS server? So why we are using DNS server? So whenever we are communicating to computer, when you are connecting on internet, so we use as name. I use as google.com or facebook.com. But computers generally mainly communicate with IPs. They are not communicating with the name. So in my computer, suppose in my computer, I am typing facebook.com or yahoo.com. So when I type microsoft.com, so I type www.yahoo.com. But generally, originally, this communication is happening with IP. So this need to go to through internet. It has to go through some Yahoo server. Yahoo server is displayed in somewhere. So, but I cannot communicate using the name. So what I will do is there is a server called DNS server. So the DNS server will help to give the IP of this server. So I will contact this server, the client machines, they will contact this DNS server and they will ask what is the IP of yahoo.com, and simple language I am telling. So they will give the IP address, and when I get the IP address, I will communicate to Yahoo. So this message will go through a router. So all the internet communications are happening through router. This communication will go happen. See, the DNS server maintaining a database. So it is similar to a telephone directory, telephone book. As we know that telephone directory, they will maintaining all the users names and phone number. But DNS server, they will maintain a database. So they will maintain in the database of web all the names and IP address. So they know they have a database. They know they are storing this information. What is yahoo.com IP address? What is facebook.com IP address and all, they are storing in the database. So internally there are many mechanisms are happening, but computers are getting IP address from the DNS server. Organizations, they are having internally, they are having a DNS server. Or when we are working from our home, we are getting connection from some provider. So we will get internet from them. So this provider will have a DNS server. So the function of the DNS server is for name resolution. So convert name to IP address. So that information we will be giving here. What is the DNS server address? Like in an organization, they know what is their DNS server address. But when we are working from home, so we'll get all this information automatically. So we are discussing about mainly about IP address. So we have a newer version of, so we have to remember IP version 6 is, IP version 4 we are using. This is a 32-bit IP address. So now we use that IP version 6 also we use. IP version 6 is basically 128-bit number. 128-bit number, because now IP version 4 IP address may be not sufficient, so they are using IP version 6. So this is a small introduction about IP address. Thanks for watching.